75 years of Kalakshetra that we celebrate this year. Kalakshetra was begun in 1936. Before that, Srimati Rukmini Devi had already begun the Besant Memorial School in 1934. And it's our proud privilege to inherit her legacy. The dancers have all done not less than 6 years, but up to perhaps 8 years in Kalakshetra in training. They've trained primarily in the solo format, but also do group. And what is interesting and an opportunity for them in Kalakshetra is that they are able to perform in the wonderful dance dramas that we have inherited. Srimati Rukmini Devi herself choreographed almost 25 such dance dramas. Beautiful Varnam, we value it very deeply because it was the last Varnam that she actually choreographed. These Kalakshetra dancers are trained both in the solo format, in group work, as in what you're watching now, but also in dance drama work. Program a kind of retrospective of Kalakshetra's work over the last 75 years is a good idea. Very different from anything that I've done in NCPA before. I also very much welcome what we're doing this morning, which is with children. I don't think we've ever done that before. And 2, 2, 3, 4. Okay, what did you feel? Where did you feel the pull? Go down slowly. And now lift the leg out. What does this look like to you? What does it look like to you? What? A bow and arrow. Here you go. One. And stop here. Like a table. Like a table. Put your body down and stretch out. To have the children coming in is very much part of my program. Kalakshetra is about children. It's about education. I don't think the arts in India are going to be very healthy or survive if they remain exclusive to an intellectual discourse or to dancers of merit. If his toes are up, then he pulls on the lower muscle, and if his toes are down, then he's pulling on the muscles on top of the shin. Now, these are both very good for you, but also you're pulling on the groin. You're pulling on the muscles right underneath the leg. And that's very good, because when you stretch a muscle, when you lengthen a muscle, you get more agile. Come on, let's see some good jumps. It's about accepting it as part of our lives. And therefore, we've got to share it with our children, because they are the inheritors. It's as much their inheritance as it is yours and mine. This particular 3-day season is like a homecoming, as well as a wonderful way of summing up what an institution in the country is doing. During the freedom struggle, many very eminent Indians felt, what is this? What's happening to us? We're under British rule. We've got systems of education that are not ours. We've forgotten our culture. We've forgotten our inheritance. We have even religions that are being forgotten. Let's start schools for Indians that we can be proud of, where the arts are part of education. How many years of independence? How many? 60. Above 60, right? Above 60. After 60 years of being independent, we still do not know much about our arts. Now, whose are they? Are they mine? Are they only? Do they belong only to these people? Are they not yours? They're yours for the asking. They're yours. They're your inheritance. It's your right as an Indian. If you have a right over anything, you have a right over your history, over your arts, over your crafts, over what is indigenously you. What is you? What is it to be Indian? Is to be able to sing those lullabies that your grandmother sang, to be able to do the cooking that your grandmother did, to be able to pass on a craft from grandfather to grandson, to be able to dance like your mother danced. This is what it is to be something that comes from the ground, you know, and is you right in your heart. So a young lady, not much older than you. How old would the oldest among you be? 16? 17? Yes? She was only in 1934. She was just a little older than y'all. She had a fire in her belly, and she wanted to see an India that appreciated its own arts. And so she started a school called Kalakshetra. Now they're going to start doing some adavas. Do some natadavas, please. Now they are exploring space. I think the dance forms have to be disseminated. They have to be made practical, usable. What were they doing? They were doing, can you show me what you were doing? They were doing extensions. So when you have space, you want to extend your arm into space. So one of the big things is about extensions. Now he was doing a different kind of extension. Forward extension, an upward extension, an outward extension. Okay, and he was also covering three levels. He's sitting, now he's standing, And now he's sitting right down. So he's explored three levels. Show me the three levels. Muramandikami. This is sitting, squatting. This is half sitting like you're doing in a different way. And this is standing. In different ways, even through ultimately the electronic media, we hope that we can make an inroad into the lives of children. Because simple questions that are asked perhaps once a year in a classroom about who is the most well-known Bharatanatyam dancer you know or whatever has to transform into, you know, good computer games where children can actually download a bit of footage. They can also see an artist, comment upon it, put it back on the web. Oh my God, we have so many snakes. We have so many snakes here.
I think the kids were brilliant. I mean, the atmosphere they built for us, you know, we had energy, they had equal or even more energy than us, you know, and the way they were interacting with us.
I have a question for all, so whoever answers.
Yes.
How long does it take to get all your mudras and, you know, your jumps and everything perfect?
We have a course for 4 years. It's okay. A diploma course. And after that, you have a 2-year course and it's a post-diploma.
You had shown peacock and other types of animals. Can you show how it's a tiger?
Being in Bombay and being in NCPA has been really fun and exciting. It's been a lot of hard work, but we've had a lot of fun. We really enjoyed the lecture demonstration with the kids.
My friends are shy to say this, so I'm saying it from them. It's for Christopher.
Yes.
They are asking that if he doesn't know Hindi, how does he dance on this song?
Oh, but he knows Tamil. He knows Tamil. He needs to know Sanskrit and Tamil, and he knows those.
Can he speak a few lines?
Can you speak a few words in Tamil to me?
Namaskaram, Akka. Eppadi irukkeenga? Saaptirukkeengala, Akka?
He asked whether I've eaten. He said, saptingla. I said, yes. Neenga vandu Delhi belly paathirukkeengala?
Paathirukken.
This was a first time experience for us with 900 children. And they gave us so much energy. We also teach part-time children at Kalakshetra. These school children who take up hobby classes. So it is, we have to think how to approach them. But today, just looking at them, you give them anything, they're like a sponge, they take it inside. So, you know, it's a big responsibility for us, you know, to take this art to the children.
The lecture demonstration, I thought, was the highlight because we've never done something like that, got to talk to the kids.
And there should be more of that, yeah. We feel.
We want to do more things where we can get to the community and talk to everyone. So in the all, Bombay was great.
It was a great experience for all of us, especially because Akka also danced today and we could, you know, share the stage. I mean, we're nowhere close to her, but still, it was a great experience for us.
Ardha Narishwaram. अर्धनारीश्वरम्
na 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 na